Hello students, we are once again here with the topic of subtraction, regrouping and borrowing. Children, in this you are going to learn regrouping of the sum, subtraction and how to borrow it. Okay, now see children, a small example I want to give. Suppose if a neighbor is there, suppose if you are at home and some guests have come to your house and you want to give them a tea. So if sugar is not there, what you will do? You cannot run to the shop and you buy the sugar. It is better you take a help of your neighbor and then you prepare. Now you must be thinking, why ma'am is giving the example of sugar, tea, neighbor, guest, all these things. In this sum, in an easy way, how to regroup and how to borrow it, I'm not going to show what is given in the book. Something different I'll show you. So for that reason, I'm giving you the example of tea, sugar, neighbor and all these things. So we are going to learn in this. See children, first we have already learned how to put the sum in the column of tens and ones. Now let us subtract 18 from 45. Here already sum is given, how to solve it, but we will see in a different way. Now see, step number 1, step number 2, 3, 4, all the steps are given. But by this way, I am not going to teach. Why? Because you will get confused between this 10 tens, 1 ones and again 10 ones, all the same. So, I will show you how to solve this sum. This is tens column and this is ones column. Now, we are going to write 45 minus 18. Okay children, 45 minus 18. We are going to solve first ones column. In ones column, 5 is given and 8 is given. Now children, see, 5 is a smaller number and 8 is a bigger number. From smaller number, we cannot minus bigger number. But from bigger number, we can minus smaller number. But here it is given smaller number as 5 and bigger number as 8. Now 8 cannot be minus from the 5. So in this case, what are we going to do? So don't worry children. Just see in tens column, 4 is given. Which number comes before 4, that you have to write here on the top. Okay, in this circle, 3. And this once you have to borrow it. As I given you the example of sugar, when we don't have sugar, we borrow from our neighbor. Same way, you have to borrow 1 tens from the tens and this number will become as a 15. Okay children, now from 15, if we minus 8, 15 is the bigger number here. 15 is a bigger number here. From bigger number, you can minus smaller number. Okay, so 50 minus 8, you will get the answer 7. When we minus 8 from this 15, you will get the answer 7. Now, same way we are going to solve tens side. Here 3 is given, here 1 is given. Now 3 is the bigger number and 1 is a smaller number. So this smaller number can be minus from the bigger number. So 3 minus 1, you will get the answer 2. So as I told you in the previous video that the answer when you minus, the answer whatever you get after minusing these 2-digit numbers, the answer what you get, that is known as difference. That is known as difference. Same way children, we are going to solve the next sums in the chapter. Okay, let us see. One more example I'll give you. Already sums are given in your book. See children, this example I want to give. Okay, solve the subtract the following. Okay, subtract the following. Here these two circles are given to regroup it and here the column is given of tens and ones. From 28 you have to minus 19. So in this way, how are we going to do? Now again, as I told you, 8 is a smaller number and 9 is a bigger number. we cannot minus this bigger number from smaller number. So in this case, we are going to regroup it. Suppose this 8 will become 18 and this 2 we have to cut and write here 1. Which number comes before 2? Okay, 1. And 1 tens we have borrowed here. So this number has become 18. 18 minus 9. See children, now in your fingers, if you count here, 3 cubes are given in one finger. Same way, if we take these 4 fingers, these numbers will become 12. Okay, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay children, so this is 18. From 18, if we minus 9, as I told you, in one finger we have 3 cubes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have minus. So how many are remaining? 9 are remaining. Okay, so here your answer is 9. Same way, 1 minus 1, you will get the answer 0. 0 means nothing. 0 means nothing, which you have already studied in the subtraction chapter of up to 10. What is the value of 0? Okay, you have already studied this. So 0 means nothing. Same way, these are the another examples given which you have to solve, and I will send you on the notes. So let us see the next video which we are going to learn in that word problems. Till that time, you can practice this. Thank you.